We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Something is Killing the Children, Issue 6. This is from Boom Studios. This is part one of a new storyline called The House of Slaughter, written by James Tynion IV, illustrated by Werther Dell'edera, colored by Miquel Muerto, lettered by Andworld Design, covered by Werther Dell'edera, with colors by Miquel Muerto. Assistant editor Gwen Waller, editor Eric Harburn. Now, this cover is actually probably the best one so far, even though it's still has nothing to do with what's going on. So we get yet another glimpse into what happened that night when the kids were killed, and again from the boy James's perspective. And this is absolutely pointless. It's about 5 pages of him and his friends just blathering on, and they gotta get in this thing that he loves some dude that won't date him or whatever. It's boring, and it's just there to pander to gay audiences. Then we cut to where the book should have started, which is at the hospital with James recovering from what happened last issue, and then Erica goes to the trouble of breaking Tommy's arm because she's angry, I guess. That's a really good way to solve problems. And we follow the police on their investigation of removing the newly found dead children from the cave. We learn a little bit from the one survivor, and she has a very shocking revelation for Erica. We also learn a little bit more about the order that Erica works for and her association with it, and that they have big plans of their own, and we're left with kind of a cliffhanger ending. This issue was kind of boring. There was a lot of wasted rambling dialogue that I guess is supposed to simulate TV dialogue. It worked up until now, but it's getting boring. The book is starting to really, really drag, and I've noticed it for a few issues where there was just a lot of pointless scenes. I like the book, but I don't think it's worth $4 because there's not a lot happening. It's been middle story for most of the series, and honestly, it doesn't look like it's going to get more interesting. So I'm a little bored with a lot of what's going on, and I think most of this issue was really wasted. A lot of the impact is lost by what the kid revealed, and the furtherance of the story was watered down by a lot of rambling dialogue. I think it would have been better served to have cut out the first 4 to 6 pages and started straight at the hospital scene, sped that up without the nonsense with Tommy and Erica, and kind of cut out that whole arm-breaking scene, which was completely stupid and pointless. She's telling him to get out of town and run, but if she breaks his arm, how's he supposed to drive? And his perspective on the situation is actually understandable, but they refuse to see it from anybody else's perspective, much probably like the writers. So I had a problem with it. I'm losing interest pretty rapidly, and it's got a good premise and an interesting plot, but it's just taking forever to get anywhere. It's too decompressed. You need to speed it up a little bit. I don't want to spend $50 on floppy comics for a story that could have been told in 6 issues. This was at best a 6-issue miniseries that should have been wrapped up by now, and then you could start a sequel instead of dragging this out more and more. So I'm a little disappointed with that. I'm considering dropping the book. I might give it another issue or two to see if anything picks up, but I'll probably end up dropping this one if it's going to continue to be this decompressed where they're just writing for the trades and trying to get a Netflix deal, because that's how it looks. And I'm really getting bored with that sort of storytelling. So they need to kind of pick it up or they're going to lose more interest. But that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.